I should say, a UK citizen. And I'm also an American. I grew up in America. I like to name it the buckle of the Bible Belt. I'm from Georgia. I'm from a small town outside of a university town, outside of a city in North Georgia. And where I grew up and London could not be farther apart if they tried. It's interesting. I'm also someone, I have a history undergraduate degree, American history. I'm a librarian who works in a school. I've pretty much spent my entire life studying the past and trying to convey that to the people of the future. And sometimes I wonder why, because sometimes I wonder if it's really getting through. It's interesting, I live here now because everybody has a story about what their dad or their granddad or their uncle or their grandmother did in the war, and it's always European-based, and there's these fantastic stories of people rescuing other people or liberating concentration camps and things like that, and my war stories aren't nearly as exciting, I guess. The folks that I had, my mother's father and my great-uncle were in the Pacific. They were, one was at Pearl Harbor and the other one was on the Missouri when the Japanese surrendered. So they have their own stories, but they're not the same. My war stories, the things that were passed down in my family, are not things to celebrate. I'm from Georgia. My entire family fought in the Confederate Army. Everybody that fought in the Civil War fought on the side of the South. And when I was growing up and I was taught my genealogy and my family history, that's what I was taught. I was taught about, you know, Charles Stark, my great-great-great-whatever uncle who lost a finger at, you know, wherever he lost a finger at. I don't know. I had family that was at Appomattox with Robert E. Lee. So when we look at things like in Charlottesville and we look at these monuments and people try and tell you that this is about their heritage, this is about their history, and this is something to be celebrated, I'm here to tell you that if there was something to be celebrated, if there was a heritage to be owned and to be proud of at this point, that I could claim that. And I won't, and I refuse to, because it's not about heritage, it's about hatred. It's always been about hatred, and it is just yet another justification that people, sad, sad, desperate little people, use to try and justify their own feelings of inferiority. And there's a certain element, I guess, here of preaching to the choir, which is not something I'm very good at either, not having been raised religious. But you know it, we know it, I know it. When is the rest of the world going to wake up and know it? And that's going to be when we are continuing to call out people's prejudice and bigotry and racism and sexism and every single ism out there. It's going to be when we continue to speak up, and it's going to be, like has been said and has been called after Charlottesville, it's time for white Americans like me to stand up and to say something, which is why I'm up here right now. So thank you for listening.